welcome back to another session of project scheduling and resource leveling. Students, in the previous session of this project scheduling and resource leveling, we have started with the introduction to chapter, importance of resources, objects of resource planning, methods of resource allocation. There were two methods, resource smoothing and resource leveling. We have conducted the resource smoothing method with an example. Resource smoothing is done when there is restriction on the project duration. When you have said that the project to be completed in 30 days, then and only then you need to apply resource smoothing by fluctuating the float available with the non-critical activities. That is what we are doing in the smoothing method. Today, in this session, we are going to learn resource leveling and scheduling. And we are going to cover main two topics in the scheduling. There are several topics such as what is scheduling, advantages, procedure, types of schedules, etc. So major, there are two topics, resource leveling with example and scheduling. So let us begin with resource leveling. So students, in a project, the activities may require varying number of resources. The demand on specific resources should not be exceeds than the availability of the resources. If the demand of particular resources has been increased by its availability, then we have only one option, to delay the activity which has the maximum flow, and that process is known as resource leveling. Again, I am repeating it again, that in a project there are number of occasions when to complete the activities we require large number of resources. But in a real-time situation, it may happen that a resource has a particular limit, and in such situation we need to delay the activity, non-critical activity, by the maximum float, so that we can manage the demand and the availability of the resources. That process is known as resource leveling. So in a project, if there are more than one resource, if there are more than one activity which requires same resource to perform the activity, then the activity which has the minimum resource, has been selected for the resource reallocation. So resource leveling has been adopted when there is restriction on availability of the resources. So that is your resource leveling. Now let us see the step-by-step process of resource leveling. So here is the step number one, that peak requirement of the resources has been carried out, and that peak requirement has been lowered by staggering of resources on non-critical activity, and if required, the subcritical and critical activities resources are also being used to lower down that peak requirement of the resources. And by doing so, it may happen that the completion of the project may get delayed. Yes, in smoothing, students, in smoothing, there was time restriction. Here, the project can get delayed by doing resource leveling. Second step is, either some of the concurrent activities may be placed in series, or some of the critical activities are being delayed to adjust the peak requirement or to lower the peak requirement of the resources. And this will increase the time duration. The next step is, rearrange the activities having larger amount of float. So that is your step-by-step process for resource leveling. Now let us see the example for resource leveling. So the question says that a network is given in the question, or the diagram of the network is given to us. In that, in the bracket, the machine requirement or resource requirement has been displayed, and the below the arrow duration has been displayed. Now, we need to level out the resources. If the maximum number of masons per day is limited up to 7. So, that is your question. Now, let us see the network diagram. So, here is the network diagram given to us. In this network diagram, along with the activity, above the arrow, that is mason requirement, and below the arrow, that is activity duration. So, first step, as according to it, we have done in the resource smoothing, first step is we need to perform forward and backward path analysis. Let us do that. So, here are the calculation for forward path analysis, and we have got the final duration as 15 days. Now, let us see the backward path calculation. So, here is the calculation for backward path analysis. Now, on the basis of forward path and backward path, let us calculate, let us prepare the table of floats. So, here is the table of floats having the column of EST, EFT, LST, LFT and the total float column with the remarks. So, here is the entire calculation that EST above the arrow ahead value, LFT below the arrow, behind the arrow, below the value, or end of the arrow, below value, and EFT plus duration of EST and LST, LFT minus duration, total float, either start time subtraction, either finish time subtraction. So, you know all the formulas we have done, we are doing this from since chapter number 4, so that is how we can prepare the entire table. Now, as we know that the total duration of the project is 15 days, let us prepare day by day chart of the mason requirement. So, here is the day by day chart of the table for the mason requirement that in activity 1, 2, 4 masons are required, for activity 1, 3, 3 masons are required and so, and above below that there is a total masons required for particular project. Now, here as you can see, initially 11 labors are required, then 7 labors are required. So, let us prepare the histogram. So, as we have seen the histogram, the peak is 11, we need to minimize it up to 7. And to do so, let us come back to the table of floats. So, as you can see in the table that activity 1, 2 and 2, 6, A and G, both are having 8 number of floats. So, we will delay the non-critical activity by 8 days. For an example, if A2, 1, 2 was starting from day number 0 to 8, now we will start the activity after 8 days. First float, then activity. Currently, first activity, then float was there. So, we'll rechange as first 8 days float, then activity. And similarly for activity 2, 6. And now, let us prepare the mason table. So, here is a reallocation of the labors, and as you can see, now the peak requirement has been balanced. So, that is how we can perform a resource leveling. Students, here we have not changed the project duration. We have not changed the project duration because it was not necessary. So, while doing the resource leveling, it is not compulsory that always project will get delayed. But if we are not leveling correctly, if we are not managing the project well, we may get delayed the project while doing the process of resource leveling. It is not compulsory. Keep that in mind. So, I hope we are clear about resource leveling. Now, let us move forward with our second topic, that is scheduling. So, scheduling is the second stage after planning has been completed. Now, we know that scheduling is related to time, but let us talk about the technical definitions. So, scheduling is the mechanical process to setting up the order of various planned activities by fixing the start date and the finish date for each part of the work, such as the whole work is to be done in systematic manner. So, that is your scheduling. See, students, every time in a project, being an engineer or being a construction manager, our aim is to always stick to the schedule. We always try that all the works get completed as per our time. But some variations are bound to happen which are beyond our control and they cannot be judged while making the planning or scheduling, or they cannot be interpreted or forecasted while doing the scheduling process. So it is necessary to reschedule the project during the progress of the work. So that is what I am trying to convey by the scheduling, that you know about scheduling, but now we need to reschedule as per the project progress appears. Scheduling thus determine at which time the operation or the event connection with the construction will take place. For an example, a railway map will tell the passenger about the road, route of the journey, but the time schedule will give his the idea that at what point his journey will begin and at what point he will reach his destination. So now let us see the importance and the advantages of scheduling. So students, scheduling will give clear idea about type and the quantity of materials required at the different stages of the project. Second, it will also give the idea about the equipment or the plant which is required to perform the activity so that we can cut the unnecessary cost. For an example, if I know that I need RMC or I need concrete mixture of this time only, so I will be keeping away from the unnecessary cost from day one. Next is, it will help in arranging the labor, skilled and unskilled, also the quantity and the time, at what time we required what kind of labor. And the same goes with money, that at what project stage, what kind of amount of money we required to perform the particular activity. So, scheduling will help us knowing all four resources, man, money, material and machinery. That at what time of project, what kind of resource, in what quantity, in what amount we require. Apart from that, the basic point is that it will give us the total time for the project completion, and from the actual progress of the work, we can know that we are lagging behind the schedule or we are making slow progress, and if we are making slow progress, how we can speed up the activities and match the actual schedule. And the project schedule is the basis of preparing the other, extracting the other schedules and information. So that is your advantages or importance of the project scheduling. And the last point that you can say is that the project scheduling work as a baseline, that is a base schedule at which you can measure the actual progress of the work in terms of time, cost, etc. Now let us see the step-by-step process of preparing this project schedule. So the first step is identify and study the scope of work which is to be done by a construction company. Then decide the construction methodology within which the project has to be completed in given time frame. Then the fine total project is broken down into number of activities and events, work packages and task level, and basis of that the network diagram by the CPM or PERT method has been prepared. Now, from the network diagram, month-wise or week-wise schedule has been prepared, and if there is a large project involving sub-projects, then there is master schedule has been prepared in addition with the preparation of the sub-project schedules. And the last step is, these schedules are needed to be revised as and when information is, new informations are available to the planning department. So that is your step-by-step process of project scheduling. Now, let us see, there are number of types of schedules used in the project. So here are the classification of the schedules which are being used in a project. The first is construction schedule, material schedule, equipment schedule, labor schedule, finance schedule, then invoice schedule, staff schedule, then milestone event schedule and specialized agency schedule. So there are total 9 schedules which are being used in the construction industry. So you know the purpose of preparing this kind of schedule, that construction schedule has been prepared for the execution of the, or preparing the roadmap of the entire project. Then material, to know the material quantity at what stage, what kind of quantity, which material quantity, So that is material, then labor. So you know about the schedules which are being prepared for the particular resource or the particular agency or the work. Now let us see the very important topic which I've mentioned to forgot initially, difference between resource smoothing and leveling. There is a clear difference between smoothing process and leveling process. So let us see the difference between them. So here is the clear difference between resource smoothing and resource leveling. So the first point says that in resource leveling, while doing the process of resource leveling, it may happen that project duration gets changed. While resource smoothing has been done after resource leveling, but while doing the resource smoothing, the project duration does not get changed. That is the first difference, that in resource leveling, the project duration can be changed, but in resource smoothing, the resource, the time duration cannot be changed. The second point is, resource leveling is primarily driven by resource constraint. That means, for a particular resource, you don't have more than 45 man hours per week for a particular labor. While resource smoothing has more to do with the desired limits. That means, like for a particular resource, we have 45 man hours per week, but we wish to apply for 35 hours only for having some breathing space. So that is the difference between resource smoothing and leveling. The third point is, as discussed in second point, that limitation, resource limitation is identified while doing the resource leveling, while desired limit has been identified by doing the resource smoothing. And the last step is that first in a project, resource leveling has been done, then and after that, resource smoothing can be done. So that is your clear difference between resource leveling and resource smoothing. So I hope we are clear about it. So we have studied all the aspect of resources. That what is resource, what is the importance of, what are the objects of resource planning, methods, numericals, and the difference between two methods. Apart from that, we have learned about what is schedule, how to schedule, types of schedule, advantages and importance of schedule. So from next session onwards, we are going to start with a very important topic, that is time cost trade-off. What is that we have learned? We are going to learn in the next session. So this is it. That was all about in today's session. In case of any query or doubt, you can always contact me on my mail or my number. Thank you.